Hello everyone, welcome back to Login Helps. In today's tutorial video, I'll be guiding you through how to download WeChat application on your device. Watch the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. In order to download WeChat application on your device, make sure you have a good internet connection first. Once you do, tap open your Play Store or your App Store and search for WeChat in the search box. Soon after you do that, tap on the first application you see, and this one's the app we are looking for. Simply tap on the install button in order to download the application on your device. The download speed entirely depends upon your internet speed. Until it downloads, let me tell you what WeChat is. It is a mobile text and voice messaging communication service developed by Tencent in China. It was first released in January 2011, and the app is available for Android, iPhone, BlackBerry, Windows Phone platforms as well. It has over 700 million downloads with 300 million active users. Wait until it installs on your device. Once it downloads, you can go ahead and tap on the open button, or you can find it in the app list as well. That is how you can download WeChat application on your mobile device. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone, welcome back to Login Helps. In today's tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to sign up for WeChat. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel if you've not yet. Press the notification icon so that YouTube will notify you whenever we post a new video. First thing you'll need to have in order to sign up to WeChat is a WeChat application installed on your device. Go to your Play Store and download WeChat first. Once you're done, tap open the WeChat application, and from the very first interface, you can select the language from the upper right corner by tapping on language. Now select your preferred language and tap on save button at the upper right. In order to sign up, tap on the sign up button at the bottom right corner, and you have two options when it comes to signing up to WeChat. You can sign up with your mobile phone or with a Facebook account. Select any one option you want. On the next page, type in your name in the first text field. You can upload a profile picture by tapping on the camera button at the right corner. From the pop-up, allow WeChat access to your photos, media, and files by tapping on allow. Choose a picture for your WeChat profile from the gallery. After you do that, you can readjust your picture, and after you're done, tap on the OK button at the bottom right. Now, you uploaded yourself a profile picture. In the region option, you'll need to select your country, give it a tap, and select your country from the list. Now enter your mobile number in the next text field. After you're done, enter a password you want to use for your account. Agree to the terms of service by tapping on agree to terms of service and tap on sign up. Go through the information once and tap on I have read and agree to the terms above and tap next. Tap on got it and allow WeChat to make and manage phone calls from your device. Go through a security verification process by tapping on start. Drag the slider to fit the puzzle piece for verification. Soon after you do that, you'll need to enter the verification code sent to your mobile number via SMS. After you enter the code, tap on the next button, and after you do that, you'll be signed up for WeChat. This is your chat screen where the list of the conversation will be displayed. Tap on the contacts tab and you can add new friends on your WeChat by tapping on new friends. That is how you can sign up for WeChat. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Login Helps. In today's video, I'll be guiding you through how to log into WeChat account on your mobile device. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. The first thing you can do is tap open your WeChat application from your app drawer. If you don't have the app installed on your device, first go to your Play Store or your App Store and download it on your device. Once you're done, you can change the language settings from the very first interface of WeChat. Go to the top right corner and tap on language and select the language of your choice. Tap on save at the upper right one more time. Now, if you don't have an account yet, you can start by tapping on sign up at the bottom right corner and register yourself to a new account first. Once you have an account, you can tap on the login button. On the next page, you can select your region from the very first option, select your country, and once you do that, enter your mobile number on the next field. You also have other options while logging in to WeChat. Tap on Other Login Options and you can log in via WeChat ID, email, or QQ ID. You can also log in to WeChat with your Facebook. After you're done, tap on the next button and tap on Got It. Allow WeChat to access photos, medias, and files on your device by tapping on Allow. Allow more access, and on the next page, you'll need to enter WeChat account's password. You can also log in with SMS verification code option. If you don't want to enter the password, simply tap on Login via SMS verification code and tap on the Send button to receive the code. Wait until you receive it. First, confirm your mobile number by tapping on OK and wait until you receive the verification code. Once you receive the code, simply copy the code and type it in, and after you're done with the code, tap on Login. Wait for a few seconds, and soon after that, you'll need to go through a security verification, drag the slider to fit the puzzle piece, and with this, you'll be logged in to WeChat. That is how it is done. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Login Helps. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to change your WeChat account's password. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how, and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. To change your WeChat account's password, tap Open your WeChat application from your app drawer. If you are not signed in, make sure you are first. Once you're in, from the chat screen, tap on the Me button at the bottom right corner, and doing this will take you to your profile. From your profile, tap on Settings. Now, tap on Account Security at the top of the screen. Tap on Password option in the third row, and on the next page, you can enter your old password into the old password text field. After you do that, move on to the next field and enter the new password you are trying to change to. After you're done, confirm the password by typing it again, and once you do that, tap on the Done button at the upper right corner. And with this, you have successfully changed your WeChat account's password. Tap on OK, and that is it. I hope you learned how to do it. If you did, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll be back soon with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Login Helps. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to reset your WeChat account's password when you've forgotten the password during the login process. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how, and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. Start by tapping Open WeChat application. Soon after you do that, you'll be taken to a page where you'll need to enter your password. During the sign-in process, when asked to enter your password, at times when you don't remember your password, what you can do is tap on Unable to Login at the bottom of the screen. Now, in order to retrieve your account's password, you have three options. You can either use Mobile Linked option, QQ ID Linked, or Email Linked. If you choose Mobile Linked option, then you'll need to log in via mobile and SMS code. Similarly, you can log in via QQ ID and password as well. If you choose to use the Email Linked option, then you'll receive a reset password option via email address. Let me tap on Email Linked option. After you do that, you'll need to enter your email address in the text field. Once you do that, make sure to enter a valid email address that is associated with WeChat. Now tap on the next button. A message has been sent to your email. Simply go and check your email, and you can follow the instructions to reset your password. To log in with your SMS verification option, tap on Login via SMS verification option and tap on Send, and WeChat will now send you a verification code to your mobile number. Confirm the mobile number by tapping on OK from the pop-up. Once you receive the code, enter the verification code in the text field. Now, tap on the Login button. And that way you'll be logged into your WeChat accounts via SMS verification. If you want to change your password, then you'll need to use the email verification option and follow the instructions to reset your password. That is how it is done. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone, welcome back to Login Helps. Today, I'll be guiding you through how to block someone on WeChat. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. Like any other messaging app, WeChat allows you to block and unblock contacts of your preferences easily. Here's how you can do it. The first thing you'll need to do is tap Open WeChat application from your app drawer. Inside the app, tap on the Contacts button at the bottom of the screen. Now, all of your contacts on your WeChat have been listed below. Select a contact you want to block, and doing this will take you to a next page. From this page, tap on the three dots at the upper right corner. From the expanded menu, tap on Block and enable the button. When you block someone on WeChat, you will not receive any messages from them and you will not see each other's moments updates. If you wish to block the person anyhow, tap on OK and there you go. The person has now been added to blacklist and the contact has now removed from your contact list as well. If you wish to unblock the person back again, then all you need to do is go to the Me button at the bottom right and from this page, tap on Settings. Under Settings, tap on Privacy and from this page, select Blocked List. You'll be able to see the list of the people that you've blocked in this page. Tap on the contact you want to unblock and one more time tap on the three dots at the upper right corner. Go to the block option and disable the button and the contact has been removed from block list or blacklist. That is how you can easily block and unblock a contact on WeChat. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll be back soon with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello and welcome back to Login Helps. In today's tutorial video, I'll be guiding you through how to unhide chats on WeChat. Watch the video till the end to learn how without skipping and hit the subscribe button and subscribe to our channel if you've not yet. Press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. Start by tapping open WeChat from your app drawer. Sign into your account if necessary. In order to hide a chat on WeChat, from your chat screen, keep pressing a conversation and from the expanded menu, tap on Hide Chat. From the pop-up, select Got It and tap on Hide again. The chat has now been hidden from the chat screen. Now, if you want to unhide the chat, then what you can do is simply tap open the conversation page for the contacts that you've hidden the chats for and try sending a message. Simply type in your text and tap on the send button and you'll be able to see the conversation in your chats tab back again. That way you can hide and unhide chats on WeChat. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll be back soon with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone, welcome back to Login Helps. In today's tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to delete one of your contacts on WeChat. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. To delete a contact on WeChat, go open your WeChat application first and sign into your account if necessary. From your chat screen, tap on the contacts button at the bottom of the screen and you'll be able to see all of the list of the contacts that you have on WeChat. Select a friend you want to delete. Let me tap on this one right here. And from their profile, tap on the three dots at the upper right corner. At the very bottom, you'll be able to see a delete button. Tap on delete and from the pop-up, select delete in order to delete the contact. That way you'll be able to delete a contact you no longer want to communicate on WeChat. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello and welcome back to Login Helps. In today's video, I'll be helping you learn how to create group on WeChat. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. In order to create a group on WeChat, the first thing you'll need to do is tap open your WeChat application and make sure you're signed into your account. Now, in order to create a group, from the chat screen, tap on the plus button at the upper right corner of the screen. Once you do that, tap on New Chat from the expanded menu. Select the contact you would like to have a group chat with, and once you do that, tap on the Done button at the bottom right corner. With this, you have created a group chat on WeChat. Start by entering any text you want to your group members. That is how you can create a group on WeChat. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello and welcome back to another episode of Login Helps. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to forward WeChat voice message. Before moving right into our video, I would like to request you to subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. Start by tapping open WeChat application from your app drawer. Sign into your account if necessary. From the chat screen, tap open the voice message you want to forward. Once you find it, keep pressing the voice message for a while. Now, tap on select from the pop-up. Once the message has been selected, tap on the share button at the bottom left. There are two options displayed. You'll need to tap on combine and forward. Select one of your contacts you want to send the voice message to and tap on done at the upper right. Now, once you do that, tap on the send button from the pop-up and you'll be able to forward WeChat voice messages. That is how it is done. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll soon be back with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Login Helps. In today's tutorial episode, I'm going to show you how to notch someone on WeChat. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button and hit the notification bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. Tap open your WeChat application first and sign into your account. The WeChat nudge is a new function on WeChat by which users can double tap another user's profile photo to nudge them. This virtually shakes user's profile's photo and sends a vibration notification to them. If you want to get someone's attention but you are tired of typing anything, then you can now nudge them. The nudge feature is especially handy if you want to notify a certain person in a group chat. Let me tap open this group chat over here. From your conversation screen, tap on the three dots at the upper right corner. Now, you'll be able to see the group member's profile at the top. In order to nudge them, simply double tap the user's profile, and that way you can get someone's attention on WeChat. Simply double tap the recipient's icon and they will receive a little nudge. That is how you can nudge someone on WeChat. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Feel free to comment down in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll see you soon with more tutorial episodes again. Goodbye till then. Hello everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Login Helps. In today's tutorial episode, I'm going to show you a step-by-step process on how to delete your WeChat account when you no longer want to use it. Keep watching the video till the end to learn how and subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss another update from us. In order to delete WeChat account, tap open your WeChat application from your app drawer and log into your account if necessary. After you're in, tap on the Me button at the bottom right corner, and after that, tap on the Settings tab. From this page, go to Account Security at the top. Now, at the bottom of the screen, tap on WeChat Security Center and select the option that says Account Cancellation. Scroll all the way down and tap on Request Cancellation. Before confirming your account cancellation, remember that after canceling your WeChat account, it cannot be restored. After you do that, tap on I have read the important notice and tap on Confirm Account Cancellation at the bottom of the screen. Now, confirm your account cancellation by tapping on Confirm Account Cancellation from the pop-up. Wait for a few seconds and your cancellation request has been completed. That means your WeChat account has been deleted. That is how you can delete your WeChat account if you no longer want to use it. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Comment down below in the comment box if you have a question or a feedback for us. I'll be back soon with more tutorial episodes. Goodbye till then.